These quick start tutorials are made using Marvelous Designer 11 and its new UI. If you would like to learn the software versions below 10, please visit our YouTube channel. For your convenience, every tutorial is made using the regular mouse settings.
We've learned how to make garments in Marvelous Designer through the previous tutorials. Now, let's learn how to make your garment look more realistic. The first thing we can do is apply a fabric preset to this shirt. Go to the library and double-click Fabric to access the fabric presets that come with Marvelous Designer. Using the search bar, we can type in keyword to quickly search the library. Hover over an image with your mouse to check the details. I'm choosing Knit Cotton Jersey and dragging and dropping it to the Fabric tab under the Object Browser. Dragging a fabric onto a pattern in the 2D or 3D window will assign it to that pattern. Double-click on the fabric to access its properties. Under Physical Property Preset, you can choose from a different fabric preset in the drop-down list. Every fabric preset from the library comes with a texture diffuse map and a normal map. You can assign a new texture map image by clicking this button, or remove it by clicking the trash can button next to it. You can also change the color of the fabric. Click on the square next to the color and pick a color from the palette. To assign this fabric to multiple pattern pieces, select the pattern pieces and in the object browser next to the fabric, click the Assign key. You can make a copy of the fabric by selecting it and click on the Copy button. Double-click on the name to make text changes. I will change the color of this fabric to a lighter color and assign it to the pocket. Using the spacebar hotkey to toggle the simulation on. You can see that the wrinkles of this garment look different compared to the default fabric. For more detailed wrinkles, you need to decrease the particle distance. Select all of the pattern pieces you would like to change and go to the property editor. Input 5 for particle distance. A 5mm particle distance will create accurate wrinkle details when working at human scale. Go to the display mode of the 3D window and turn on fabric display to mesh. We can see that the mesh become much more dense. Lowering the particle distance will reduce the speed of simulation. Therefore, it is best practice to have a higher particle distance while working and lower it at the end. Let's turn the fabric display mode back to textured surface and apply some top stitching to this shirt. The top stitch tool is located in the toolbar of the 2D window. I'm going to change the fabric object browser to Topstitch to access its properties. Select the segment Topstitch tool. Click on an edge line or internal line to apply it. Zooming in the 3D window, we can see that the topstitching is applied near the edge line. Double-click on the Topstitch from the object browser and we can edit its properties. You can change the type to texture and bake it into your texture maps during export, or leave it as OBJ to export as geometry. Under Shape, you can choose one of the top stitch styles that come with Marvelous Designer. You can also edit the length, width, space, and thickness of the top stitch. If you made a custom top stitch, you can import it under Custom OBJ. I will change the color of the top stitch to something near the color of the t-shirt. Under Offset, you can give more or less offset from the edge. Next, I will apply this top stitch to some other edge lines of this shirt using the segment top stitch tool. Under the top stitch object browser, I'm going to add a new style and add it to the pocket edge line using the free top stitch tool. Next, I'll rematch the shirt into quads. Turning on Mesh Display for the garment in the 3D window for best visualization. Select all pattern pieces. I will first increase the particle distance just to make the remeshing process faster. Right-click on the garment and choose Remeshing. You can also remesh one or more pattern pieces by selecting them and going to the property editor and turn on Remesh. You can change the density of the mesh after remeshing using the particle distance. Turn the display back to texture surface and lay out the UVs for the shirt. I'm going to change the 2D window to the UV editor. Right-click at the empty space in the UV editor, and choose Reset UV to 2D Arrangement for a cleaner look. Select all of the UV shells and scale them down uniformly. Fit the UV shells into the 0 to 1 square space. Make sure to put these small shells in the square space as well. In this case, they are the UVs of the top stitches. In other cases, they can also be the UVs for the buttons, zippers, or other geometry elements in the scene.
Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe for more tutorials for Marvelous Designer. And if you have any more questions about our software, feel free to comment down below, check out our website, forum, or Discord channels linked in the description.